So if you are starting on creating a funnel, or even if you've created some funnels in the past, but you've used templates, or maybe you didn't even know you were supposed to use templates, you might start thinking about funnel design and kind of taking it to the next level and what is required. What is good funnel design? What is bad funnel design? What does funnel design have to do with my business? How will it change the outcome and the success of the funnels that I launch? So I'm gonna go over today all the things about design, why design is important, how you know if a funnel is a good design or not, like my definition of good design, which is actually not decoration as most people think it is. So we're gonna dive into the strategy of designing for your funnels and how to make yours look amazing. Let's go.
So I want to show you guys a visual of this kind of workflow between bad design, good design, and why these things are bad. I am trying to kind of hone your eyes a little bit into understanding what's good design and what's bad design when it comes to funnels. Because remember, design covers the gamut. We're talking about branding, logos, patterns, textiles. I mean, there's so many different types of design, right? Not just funnel design. So this is specifically to funnel design. These are not things that I learned from design school. Well, some of them, but can't really take that out of me. These are actual, like, real life, the design streets, the mean streets of funnel design, right? And what I've learned in how people buy and why people buy. So I want to just kind of clarify that, because a lot of people who do this type of design nowadays don't understand how people buy. And just because you were taught in design, just because you maybe have a degree or whatever, or you just because you understand other types of design, does not mean you understand funnel design, what's good for a funnel design. And this is very different, and I want to go over that for you guys today. And I want to clarify, just kind of clear up, what is bad design versus good design. A lot of these things that I say, you might be a little convicted, and you know, when I say this, you might be like, oh, I'm making that mistake. And this is not to, like, look down on anybody or say that, hey, like, this is bad, you're bad, right? It's just like, this is a learning experience, and I want you to get better at this. I'm gonna show you why it's bad, and then I'm gonna show you, like, what the flip side is and how you can improve it. If you have any questions on this, make sure to shoot us, you know, in the comments. Feel free to hang out with us. We have a Facebook group called Marketer's Heart, where we talk all about kind of design stuff. And Funnel Gorgeous, you can just shoot us an email at Funnel Gorgeous, any of those things. So I don't want you to feel like down on anything. I don't want you to feel like I'm saying your design is bad or anything like that. I just want to show you guys the truth of what bad design looks like versus good design in funnels. First, we're going to go over the bad design principles, what I consider bad design, but also what consumers consider to be bad design, because they're voting with their wallets, right? They're voting with their dollars. And so a design is a solution. A good design is a good solution. Bad design is a bad solution. So it's all equal, right? The beauty is on the eye of the beholder. But good design equals successful funnels. So I want you to start getting rid of the idea that there's a bad font that you can use, or there's a bad color. It has nothing to do with that. There's only good solutions and bad solutions. Then I'm going to tell you what the problem really is with this bad design and why it's bad for funnels specifically. And then I'm going to say what good design looks like in this same scenario and how you can fix it. So again, if you have any of these problems right now with your funnels, you'll know exactly how to fix it. Okay, so number one, bad design is no design. And what I mean by no design is, it's literally no design. It's just text on a page, or it looks like a letter, or it's just straight up scrolling black and white pictures, maybe pictures. There's no design. I think you guys know what I mean by that, right? There's thought put into them, maybe in even the copy, but there's just no design. It's not super popular for me to say this, but I don't care what people think, because I know what works and what doesn't. Sorry. But no design, the reason it's bad is that it's difficult for customers to determine if it's a good fit for them. If you give them no design, you are actually shortchanging people, because it's really difficult for customers and consumers or clients to understand your offer. You're actually, like, making your offer more convoluted, and they're not going to, like, quite understand without the visuals. So it's almost like if you were to shut your eyes and just hear something without seeing it, you're, like, missing half the picture. Same idea. When you're reading and there's no design, you're just reading it, like, almost like your eyes are closed and you're just listening to it and you're not seeing any visuals, right? I hope that metaphor makes sense, because it really is true. It's basically like checking out your whole funnel, like, in an audible way, like an audio, and not seeing any visuals, right? What good design is it's thoughtful design that aids in the comprehension. So literally good design, it's not pink isn't bad, blue isn't bad, green isn't bad. It has nothing to do with that. It has to do with design that is thoughtful for the offer, for the copy, for everything that you're trying to sell, for the person you're trying to sell it to, that actually aids in the comprehension of what your offer is. That is good design. So good design is not a style. Good design is helping someone understand what you offer. So that's going to help us kind of throw the rest of this. Spammy design is bad design. I know you guys know this. This is stuff that you see like pop up, or used to be like way more prevalent back in the day. What we would see, this like spammy design, flashy red arrows, this whole thing, like just super duper spam fantastic, right? And you're just like, right? You just like need to like shake it off after you see it. Problem with it is it cheapens your brand. Number one, you look like, you know, if you're trying to be, I don't know, like someone on the side of the street selling, you know, slinging your wares, not a real business, or flash in the pan, or literally a scam, right? When people see these like spammy designs with flashing moving arrows and all this stuff, it's like, what are you overcompensating for when you have this like spammy design and you go to all these like tricks and like trying to like fool people and just giving you money? It like screams scammer, and people are like, nope, I'm not gonna put my credit card in there just because it looks scary. It's like going into like a scary neighborhood like funnel, right? Where you're like, this looks sketchy. I think they might steal all my money. Like, this is what spammy design means. And this is why I also say number two, it fools no one. Just because you have a flashing thing with arrows, people are smarter than that nowadays. And just because you flashed arrows at them doesn't mean like, oh my gosh, I need to get my wallet. Like, it doesn't. I really think that people think this, but it doesn't work for real humans. It doesn't work for non-spammy humans. It's just not who I'm sure you are. If you're watching this video, if you've seen anything that we put out, you know, like, this is not your human. It fools no one, and it cheapens your brand. So what is good design? Good design is honest, it's authentic, and it shows heart. It shows the heart behind the offer. It shows the heart behind the person selling it. It shows the heart behind who it helps and who it serves. You don't have to have this smoke and mirrors, flashy disco ball, you know, yuckiness, right, to sell, because you don't have to prove anything, because you have nothing to hide. And so there's an authenticity and an honesty on this type of design that you just don't need all the flash. You just need, again, thoughtful design that aids in comprehension. So I know you guys know what I'm talking about. Over-designed. So this is one of those, sorry guys. I feel like a lot of people have this problem nowadays, and you think that design, more design equals like high end or luxury, or the more bells and whistles I put on it, it's actually a bad thing, because it detracts from the actual message. If there's too much bling, if there's too much design, if it's just too much, period, too many colors, too many shapes, too many photos, right? Like just too much. It's almost gaudy at that point. It actually is going to detract from the actual message, and it's going to basically be almost the same thing as no design, because it's going to be difficult for customers to find if it's a good fit, because they're like kind of wading through all the design in order to get the message. Not a good thing. But I will say, of all of these, this is the easiest to make a mistake on, because people think if a little bit of design is good, then a lot of design is better. That's not the case. And so you want to make sure that good design is just right, right? It's like the Goldilocks. It's not too much, it's not too little, it's just right. And how you know it's just right is that everything has a purpose. Everything on the page has a reason for being there. If there's a divider line, it's because you needed a break in thought. If there's a bullet point, it's because you needed to break up the information in a bulleted way. If there's a big photo, like the photo means something, right? So every piece of design means something for the comprehension. It means something to show the offer. It means something maybe emotionally to connect with the buyer, but every single thing on the page needs to have a reason and not be just decoration. This is where I think design gets a bad name, because people think it's decorating and it's not. I'm going to explain that in just a second. Copy and paste design. So this is bad design. So what I mean by copy and paste is that you actually take chunks of copy and paste it into a template, or just straight up any funnel, right? Or like it could almost be kind of closely tied with no design, right? But this could be like you have a template and you're just literally dropping stuff in. That's the end. I copied it, I pasted it, voila, look at what I've got. This is another thing that's like really easy trap to fall into, but it's still is bad design because it's difficult for customers to read through it and comprehend it. When you just copy and paste, it's almost like you just cut out a piece of paper and pasted it on and you just slap, 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 slap. It's still not like actually breaking down the copy, the offer. You're back to basically square one where it's not thoughtful design that's aiding the comprehension because you've just copied and pasted in. So for example, this would look like a paragraph, like maybe you're explaining something that's included in the offer and it's just a paragraph and you just took the paragraph with no formatting whatsoever and just slapped it into a square section. Well, I have no idea what to read from that paragraph. I have no idea what's the most important part of that paragraph. If I'm skimming, I have no idea, should I even read this paragraph? What does this paragraph have to do with me? And so there's no indication on the quality of the content, who the content's for. It's just chunks of text and it's overwhelming as heck. And people get super, oh my gosh, too much text, bye. Like, I don't know what heads or tails to make of this. This looks like a book, right? This looks like a big book that I have no time to read. And so this is one of those, it's like, kind of like you think you're almost there, but it's still bad design because it's still detracting from being able to understand and ultimately purchase, correct? What is good design? It indicates to the reader what is important and it also illustrates complex ideas. So you want to break down those big chunks of text, even if you're using a template, totally cool, but you want to break down those big old chunks of text into smaller bite-sized pieces. So indicate maybe even just some bold sections that are like the most important thing they need to know if they were just skimming. So if you see a paragraph and there's just like three or four words that are bolded, you can kind of understand what the paragraph's going to be about, almost like chapter markers, right? Or maybe something's underlined, or maybe it has an icon next to it to explain what you're about to talk about. But you see how there's just like one next level up from that that will explain these sections. So that when people are going through it, they can go, oh, cool, I can see that this is the section where they're going to tell me what's included. I see that this is the section where they tell me who it's for. Okay, cool. I see that this is the section that tells me all of the benefits. Okay, cool. I see, you know, exactly how much it costs. I see what's included. I see when does it start. We can start to identify and categorize these areas instead of them just being big old blocks of text. All right, and the last one is trendy design. You guys are gonna get mad at me. Mad at me for this one. Okay, trendy design's okay-ish, but it's not usually for most people. So I wanna say that trendy design has to be used very sparingly, especially in funnels. It doesn't really like have a place in funnels. It kinda does, but it kinda doesn't. It's like this balance of like, you need to know what's trendy and what's not. If you're not like a designer, you're not gonna know what's trendy or not, right? So it can go out of style really quickly. So problem with it really is that you might be actually attracting the wrong customer. If you don't understand trends versus customers and who goes with who, you might be using the wrong trend for your wrong customer, right? Or vice versa, like not using the right trend for your right customer. So it's one of those things you have to use really sparingly because you just might not understand how it works. Or like I said, it could go out of style and it can make you feel dated. Like, this brand is behind the times. I don't really know what's going on. Or you could go the other way. Like it could be super duper trendy and people are like, ooh, I don't know about this. This sounds like a brand new company. I'm going to step off, right? Not really sure about this company. You got to use these trends really carefully because they're just really potent in one way or another for good or for bad. So most of the time using trends is not a good thing, so I put it in the bad design pile. But classic design, so good design is classic design that is suited to your offer. So a design style that you know for sure fits your type of client and not just flash in the pan, what's cool right now at this moment that might detract or maybe attract the wrong person, or there's a lot of little issues that like communication that can break down. So good design has classic design, it's traditional design, it's safe design that just really, again, focuses on thoughtfulness, it aids in the comprehension, makes things easier to read and to understand. Like you just can't go wrong with the classics. So that's where I say for people to hang out in the classic zone until you are really knowledgeable about design, and then that's when you can start to kind of like go out a little bit and go on the edge and do some trendy stuff.
Now you guys see why I am so passionate about funnel design and why it is so important to think about when you are launching your funnels so that ultimately your funnels are as successful as possible and they find the people who really need what you offer. Thanks for hanging out with us. Make sure to watch our other videos all about funnel design and we'll see you on the next one. Bye guys.